to look a lot like Christmas. Good morning, Bible class students. This is our last week for Bible class before our Christmas break, and I'm excited. I know you're excited, not because I'm not going to be in the Word and teaching in Proverbs, but because Christmas is almost here, and we are on the countdown, and it's so much fun. I don't focus on the presents so much, even with my own family, but I love to focus on the sacredness of the season. So, with that being said, I'm going to create a very special Christmas presentation, a little devotional for all of my Bible class students and their families, and I'm going to put it out on December the 21st. So I'm going to put it out sometime during that day. I may go live. If you think about it, you can watch it. If not, it's okay. But it's just for those that want to join me just to remember and to celebrate together the birth of Jesus. It's not going to be a long one. So anyway, today we're going to be talking about silence. Let's title this Speech 101. Okay? Speech 101. So today our lesson is going to be about our words. It's a powerful, powerful lesson. We're going to be looking at Proverbs chapter 10, verses 8 through 19. And our focus verse is going to be verse 19. Here we are sitting right in the parking lot at Walmart in my mother's vehicle. And we're just together right here in the car together. We're going to get into the Word of God. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for every student watching, God, and for the wonderful holiday season that you're bringing us into. And we pray blessings over this word today. And we pray that you would teach us the language of heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's go to Proverbs chapter 10, verses 8 through 19. And I want you just to read it right there with me.
Proverbs chapter 10, verses 8 through 19 says, "The wise in heart will receive commandments, but a prating fool shall fall. He that walketh uprightly walketh surely, but he that perverteth his ways shall be known. He that winketh with the eye causeth sorrow, but a prating fool shall fall." Notice that is mentioned two times. It's repeated. And there's always significance when a phrase is repeated in the Bible. Verse 11, "The mouth of a righteous man is a well of life." Notice this, because this is what we're going to be talking about today. "But violence covereth the mouth of the wicked. Hatred stirreth up strifes, but love covereth all sins. In the lips of him that hath understanding, wisdom is found. But a rod is for the back of him that is void of understanding. Wise men lay up knowledge, but the mouth of the fool is near destruction. The rich man's wealth is his strong city. The destruction of the poor is their poverty." Verse 16 says, "The labor of the righteous tendeth to life, the fruit of the wicked to sin. He is in the way of life that keepeth instruction, but he that refuseth reproof erreth. He that hideth hatred with lying lips, and he that uttereth a slander is a fool." Verse 19 is our focus verse today. "In the multitude of words there wanteth not sin, but he that refraineth his lips is wise."
Wow, that was powerful, powerful verses. And so many of those verses, today's verses, has to do with the mouth and the lips. So I want to show you a little book. It's called The 40-Day Word Fast. And a group of ladies and I are going through this throughout the month of December. And it has been an eye-opener for me. So if you're a reader, I encourage you and your family to get that book and go through it together. I want to read you a little bit out of this day 21. It's called Restrain Your Speech, because it goes so well with our verse of the day. It says, "Most of us have been around someone who has an opinion about everything. Perhaps we have been that person at some point. We might call that person opinionated. However, the Bible calls them foolish. How much more prudent is it to be a person who is careful when they speak and to speak with purpose? we have all had the experience of putting our foot in our mouth by speaking before we thought about what we were about to say. Yes, I've been there. A person with an excellent spirit uses self-control with the words he speaks. He puts a bridle on his words and does not speak with haste. We've experienced the one-sided conversation with someone who is devoured by the me monster. No matter who is sharing about what, this person butts in the conversation as it has a one-up story to share in order to get attention from the other people. If you caught a big fish, he caught a bigger one. If you had two cavities filled, he had six. If you share about an accident, he had three in one day. He can top anything anyone shares. He thinks he has to speak to every conversation. He believes his opinion matters above others. In reality, he reveals his ignorance. It is a fruit-bearing exercise just to hold your tongue in some conversations and not to have to give your opinion or experience. Be sensitive today to the times where you interrupt someone in a conversation or on the phone. Holding your tongue is a discipline you will benefit from, and we all would do well to practice. Practice this discipline today and see how it feels. I thought that was worth sharing today as we learn that sometimes silence is just better. It's better to allow the other person to speak. That's a good listener. That's what Solomon is teaching us. Well, I hope that blesses you all today. I look forward to tomorrow. Tomorrow's our last official lesson for 2021. And I pray that your week is blessed, your Christmas season is blessed, and that I will see you back in January. Remember, feel free to join me on December 21st for a special Christmas presentation. God bless.